change in the lineup. Charlamb was scheduled to start second, and they moved things just a bit as Charlamb decides to go to the rear of the field. Here they come, and the green is out, and Daniel Wesson in the Monaco Ford car wastes no time at all. Oh, they touch. Wesson does a nice save. Markowski was the man who spun, and Sarah gets tangled up in it. And one other car. Last week's feature event winner, also making his presence known, Marcello Raffano. Jimmy Fuller prepares that race car. But he was a pretty happy driver after he was able to get his second career win, Marcello Raffano. So we are lined up and we are ready to go. You can also keep an eye on the 81 car, Brett Gagne, as he always seems to be in the upper tier of the field. So we are getting ready to turn up the volume. And Daniel Wesson, he lived up to his nickname on the start. Let's see if he can do it again on the restart.
Yes, he can.
Yes, he does, Matt. So the bullet is out in front. The competitive edge coating car sets the pace. Meanwhile, all of a sudden moving to the outside, no surprises here, is Corey DiMatteo. Boy, it didn't take him long to get into the top tier as he's fighting Joey Farino for second. Might have a little bit of an advantage, and he leaves Farino in the dust. The late show, Corey DiMatteo, has avalanched his way into second place.
Keep your eyes on David Root. David Root puts the big hoss machine up to the fourth position. Now, David Root started back in the 10th spot, and he's done that in less than a mile.
And right now he is going after the back bumper of Joey Farino's car as he goes to the outside of the 87. And it looks like David Arute has authority every time he takes his car to the outside edge.
David Arute continues to dig in. As now David Arute, a feature of that winner, is up to the top three. Corey DiMatteo reels in, and David Arute turned the fastest lap of the race. 19.937.
Trying to move up from the rear of the track is Wesley Crocker in car number 22. By his side is Marcello Raffano. So those two guys are teaming up to try to get back into the upper area. But it is the 92 of Wesson. He is a pretty difficult man to pass. So in his hip pocket is Corey DiMatteo and David Arute. Looking strong in the number 75.
Still the quickest car on the racetrack is David Arute. All over Corey DiMatteo in a bid for second. Meanwhile, they're doubled up side by side for the fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh spot. Marino holds off Nasella. Brett the Jet is there, and so is it Marcello Raffano.
As those four cars are fighting for fourth, and right now it's Nasella. And following them on the outside is Brett the Jet Gagne and Marcello Raffano showing some power. But nobody has an answer so far for the first seven laps for Daniel Wesson. Remember, there will be a $100 bonus distributed on lap number 13.
Daniel Wesson, it's been a long time since he's been to the winner's circle here in the SK Lights at Stafford. 19.891, the exact same time for Corey DiMatteo, the car in second, but 19.869, quicker, is David Arute in the third spot.
Raffano tried to carve his way underneath Gagne in turn two. Gagne was able to hold him off, but they're having a pretty spirited battle. Then it's Farino followed by Crocker. Now Charlamb trying to make some noise on the inside of Andrew West. And here comes David Arute. Bold move to the inside of DiMatteo.
There's no question about it. He makes a bold run for it.
As he is trying to elbow his way underneath the six, it's not happening yet. And all by his lonesome in fourth is Nasella. And look at the Jet. Brett Gagne is able to get by on the outside as Gagne shows some power against Raffano.
Good run there All of a sudden, Rafato moves to the inside of Brett, and now Rafato has moved into the top five. One lap past the halfway marker in this event.
And Daniel Ricciardo and Gagne are having their own war.
And the top three have pulled away from everybody else. And this will be the cash register lap. Deep into turn three. Ka-ching, ka-ching. As Daniel Wesson picks up the bonus money here from Ocon and Doug Dunleavy and company. Meanwhile, David Aroud is getting quicker in that third spot. Corey DiMatteo running in the tire tracks of Wesson. Wesson has led for 13 circuits in his 20-lap grind. And now David Aroud tries a different line to start to work over Corey DiMatteo. So the top three, the fitter is sleeping back.
Here comes Aroud trying to give a wake-up call to Corey DiMatteo, and the six couldn't get close enough to the inside of that car. Nacera, in his own dimension of time and space, his own comfort zone, in fourth, but the action is heating up at the front. Three drivers have an opportunity to move into the lead. It is Wesson, pursued by DiMatteo, who is being pursued by Aroud.
Those three cars at the point. Meanwhile, George Nacera trying to close up the gap. But as strong as he is, Marcello Rafato is quicker. Here comes David Aroud. Bold move to the inside of Corey DiMatteo. DiMatteo shuts the door. Aroud pulls it back in the line.
He was almost able to jackknife underneath DiMatteo, but didn't have enough velo. Let's see if he tries it again. When they hit the line, we'll be down to our final two laps. And Daniel Wesson is starting to pull away from the DiMatteo Aroud combination.
Two to go. Two laps to go. 1 mile remains in this one. David Aroud is all over Corey DiMatteo as Daniel Wesson out in front. Marcello Rafato working over Nacera. That is for the fourth spot. This time, when they come off turn number four, white flag is out. 1 lap remaining for Daniel Wesson, the point leader. Pulls away down the back straightaway. Final time into turn number three. Daniel Wesson will put the Monaco Ford competitive edge coatings car pins in that position lane. Corey DiMatteo for second, David Aroud for third, George Nacera for four, and Marcello Rafato to finish in five. And now we direct our attention to Napa Victory Lane with Daniel Wesson, tonight's winner of the SK Lights.
Okay, Dan, man, a clinic you put on tonight. Good run there. I'll tell you, the 92 was absolutely flying.
Yeah, it's on rails tonight. You know, I can't believe the six car, he stuck with me. You know, we had a fast car all day, but he got in my head, and I started overdriving a little bit, but he slipped up. I saw my mirror, so I just drove out the rest of the race, and you know, I just can't thank Jimmy Sullivan and Brian Sullivan enough. You know, they came out to my shop, and they worked on the car all week, and they made a bunch of changes to the car, and, you know, I just can't be more thankful for them.
Yeah, I'll tell you, the car looked like it was really hooked up really good tonight.
Yeah, you know, I just got to thank all my sponsors. Northeast Race Cars, Trackside Motors, Smith's Auto Body, Sarah Fabrication, Monaco Ford, 140 Buzz, Dunleavy's Truck and Trailer, Waddell, Competitive Edge Coatings, Hams Welding, Patriot Coatings, TA Motors for the big power. You know, I appreciate all the fan support and everyone who comes out and helps every week.
There he is, the bullet goes to victory lane, car number 92 in the NASCAR SK Light Modified main event. Let's talk to our second place finisher, Corey DiMatteo. Corey over here getting a drink of water, man. Congratulations, second place. The sixth car looked like coming off a turn two there with just a couple to go. You got a little loose.
Yeah, I started reeling him in, saw the gap getting closer, and I just tried playing the throttle right in the center, 1-2, and the rear tires just gave out. I think I was a little bit too low, got the left rear on the apron, de-wedged the car. But second place, not bad. Great points tonight. Car's not wrecked. I got so many people to thank. I got to thank my mother, my father, Island Cove Yacht Sales, and John Brothers, Sign Pro for the great looking race car, KKR for the great setup. There's so many Napa of Kane, my brother for helping me out in the shop, Pasta Vida, superior finishing, everyone...